Around 12:15, my phone rang. The fire department wanted to bring 50 families to us. My immediate response was absolutely. We're more than happy to help. There's a creek, the Wonderland Creek. It flooded very, very quickly. Businesses were devastated. Schools were shut down. The sheer exhaustion of having to step up at work and then go home and help neighbors. We didn't realize the emotional toll that would take on our residents and our staff.
In 2013, flash flooding and mudslides hit Boulder County, Colorado. At the time, the community was already in the process of evaluating their flood maps.
Boulder, number one in terms of flash flood risk in Colorado, because we sit at the mouth of Boulder Canyon. We advise our residents here to be informed on flood risks and the importance of purchasing flood insurance.
Every community's journey to understanding their flood risk is different. Once maps are finalized and adopted, what comes next?
We are actually doing flood mitigation projects all over the city of Boulder. It includes things like culverts and better water flow structures, upgrading bridges, so at least we'll be better prepared to weather the next event.
It's really important that we stay focused and we stay diligent. There's a lot of experts out there that are able to help us make more informed, intelligent decisions prior to an emergency or disaster.
Communities can use the data in their maps to plan development and make infrastructure improvements. Every federal dollar spent on mitigation saves $6 in future disaster costs. In high-risk areas like this coastal Virginia fishing town, small businesses are faced with important decisions about how to reduce their risk. Mitigation can save money on flood insurance and help the business reopen after a flood. As the water's edge creeps up closer and closer to properties, the flood map helped residents of Pocosin decide the actions that work best for them.
The lessons that our community learned after the 2003 storm was that all of us needed to step up our efforts towards community resilience. I'd estimate 600 homes have been elevated since 2003.
The elevation of the home process is extremely important because you're trying to take the structure out of harm's way. Generations of family have been born and raised on that property, has a rich history to it.
We use the FEMA flood maps to set our building standards for the future so that the buildings we build today will be resilient buildings decades down the road.
To learn more, contact your community's floodplain administrator. You can find your community's flood map at fema.gov/mitigation.